Hello, my name is Dimitri, and I have finally solved recurring tasks in Notion. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Hold the applause. Hold the applause.
I'm doing this for you.
Notion's a multi-billion dollar company that hasn't fixed this problem, by the way, so all I'm gonna say is, you're welcome. If you want to have a quick laugh at what this is gonna look like, this is my recurring tasks. That's right, I got everything in my business organized like this. Good God, there's so much stuff here. But you know what? You're gonna have something that's much simpler, and I'm gonna explain to you how easy this can be. So first and foremost, why are we using make.com instead of Zapier? Zapier does not allow you to connect to relations.
Which sucks.
It doesn't allow you to update icon. Its API is just basically trash in comparison to Makes for Notion. I don't wanna get mad at Zapier. Another probably billion dollar company, by the way. But, you know, they could help me out and be nice. So moving forward into Make, what you're gonna wanna do is essentially create a new scenario. And then in this make.com scenario, you're going to go here and essentially figure out what interval you're trying to work with. So say you're working with daily tasks, you're gonna have this set to recur once a day or every day. And then you can also set it to days of the week for weekly ones. You can set it to days of the month for ones like that. Or in this case, this at regular intervals thing, we'll basically set it so that it does it every certain amount of period of time as well. So say you had a specific start date in mind, you could then in theory recur it for eternity in that certain amount of time. Now, granted, leap tiers are a thing, so that's fun, but you get my point. So let's say we want to do weekly tasks on this case so that you know you're also able to take something like a Friday task and actually use a weekly automation by adding different days and setting times and whatnot. So no worries there. So for example, we're going to do a 4 a.m. recurring task thing so that essentially this automation runs at 4 a.m. because that's before, you know, I'd wake up. And just for reference, the time zone says America Denver for me. So you're going to have to figure out the time zone in regards to you because I'm in Central Time. So I can actually show you here how to change the time zone that you're going to be setting it to in comparison to what's in Notion. So let's press OK here. But every Monday, this is going to run at 4 a.m. or 3 a.m. for me because I'm Central Time. And then what you're going to do is you're going to find the Notion one here, and you're going to do create a database item. So in order to figure out how you're going to connect this to your task and event calendar, what you want to do is you want to go to Notion. And for me, I have this actions page. So you're going to want to take this full page. So what you're going to want to do is go to the main database. This is the task and event database. And you're going to want to copy this link here. And then you're going to want to do one of two things. You can either select from a list or paste. So if you want to do the paste version, what you're going to have to do is essentially take the HTTPS section, delete that, and then delete everything past the question mark. And that'll give you, if you enter it manually, the database. Now, another way you can do it, and I recommend doing that, would be search for tasks/events or whatever the name of your task database is. And then you can still copy the link and double check that this is what ends up showing. This is my personal preference. So if I click on this one, you'll see that is the same thing. Now, obviously there's some hyphens in between, but that's just how Make takes the data and puts it through. So if we press OK, essentially what this is telling the automation to do is that every Monday at 4 a.m., it's gonna create a database item. So then you're gonna need three things in order to make recurring tasks work. So first you're gonna have the create a database item, and then you're going to do append page content. Okay, so we're just gonna work through the structure of all this. So append a page content changes the data within the page because obviously database items in Notion are just pages. And then you're gonna append the page content for any sort of headers you'd wanna have or subtasks. And this is going to be mapped to the first one. And then the third step in the process will be doing a update a page. And what is the update a page for? This one is going to be adding an emoji or a cover art to your new database item. So throughout this process, if you want to press save just to make sure that things aren't lost, I'd recommend doing that. So what we're going to do is go into this, and as you'll see here, the top part has the name. So let's do an example task of every Monday, we're going to take out the trash. So then we put that title. And then for me, I have due dates and I have times, and those are different properties. And funny enough, all of these different ones here are actually relations and multi-selects and select property. So another reason we want to use make.com is because relations do not work in Zapier, which is a big problem here. So for me, we know that taking out the trash is a part of my life tree. I want to assign it to me because it works with person properties here. And then I want to set it to Monday. Now, what you're gonna know here is the fact that this is set to recur on Monday, which means if you go to the time functions here, now will be perfect for this. So if I take this, I have essentially put in everything that matters. So I've put life, I've put housekeeping here. And then if I press okay, that makes the database item. So say we want to do a page content and add anything specific to it. What we can do is we can take the page and add specific blocks inside of it. So how are we going to map this to create a database item? What we're going to do is we're going to look for this name and number, and we're going to take the database item ID because that is the same as the page ID. And we're going to add some contents. So then if we go here, what I like to do is add something like a header 3 and put text like what to do. And then another one after this, you can untoggle that and then you can add the next block. So what I'm going to do is put paragraph text and then just literally put some hyphenated lines here so that it kind of gives you a divider. And then under that, what I'm going to do is add another item and put a to-do block. So then in here, I'm going to put take out the trash. And then under that, I can put something like to-do, take out the recycling, and then furthermore, bring in trash and recycling at the end of the day. So you can see that once I press that, it would append the page content. And then at the end of this, what we're going to do is if we go to update page, we do the exact same thing and take that database ID from the first one by going back in here. You can see the one create a database item. We're going to do database item add here. And then we don't want to change the title. You can change the cover URL link if you want. What I'm going to do is change the emoji to some sort of cleaning one here. Now I know there's no trash icon on Windows emojis, which is kind of weird. I'm just going to put that here, then press OK. So then now, if I press run on this, it'll go through and create it first and then append the page content and update that page. So if we go to this little thing here and go to the URL, you can copy this, paste it in your browser, and you can find the exact task. And you can see it assigned it to me, gave me life housekeeping. I could have added a root task here because it's something that I constantly do because hopefully I take out the trash. But you can see within here, gave me the H3, take out the trash, take out the recycling, bring in trash and recycling, and it also updated this. So the time here is interesting. I said now, I'm recording this on a Thursday. So basically, if it did it at now on a Monday, it would have shown up on Monday. So what happens if we want to take the day and make it a different day? So what we're going to do here is we can actually copy this and do it quicker. So if I copy this by holding shift, left clicking and dragging, then press control C, I can press control V, press allow, and then move this over here. Then when you click off, what you'll have here is the exact same thing created. So say, for example, I had a task that I wanted to do on Tuesday to start this automation off. What I do is I take the stuff within there and edit the content, but also I would take the date property and do an add days function. So if I go here to the time section, I would use the same logic of now, but I'd go here and add days, put now, and then I'd also put one here. Now, if I want to change this info, I can do something like meal prep for work. Make sure this time I have the root task on there, then go through the other ones and change this to a food emoji, and then go within the page content and change this as well. Make sandwich, make salad, and then I could delete one of these blocks here. Press OK. Then I'm going to run this scenario again. So then if I go here, I can open up the URL again. And you'll see since today is the 13th, it will make it on the 14th. So in theory, this was made as an automation running on Monday. It would create the task on a Tuesday, which is exactly what I'd want. And then you see it changed the different sub stuff here, changed the icon. One last step to this process that's really important is that if you want to add a specific time to it, we're going to do another copy here, paste it again. So let's say I do weekly recording sessions on Saturdays. We're going to have to take the different time that I do it into account. So that would mean, let's say, for example, I record at 5 a.m. on Thursdays, for example, we're going to have to add some things in here. So let's do record videos. We're going to have to obviously change the different ancillary things here, like what part of my life is it in? It's content. Okay. It's obviously part of my content calendar. Then going back to the time piece, we said it was going to be on Thursday. So yeah, we're first and foremost going to be changing this to 3 here. However, there's something really important that you need to do, which is add a set hours to your time here. And what this is going to tell the automation to do is literally just set the time. So what you're going to do is you're going to go before this now here. You're going to press the calendar here, do set hour, and you're going to take this now property, put it right here. So if I delete that and then put it right next to set hour, then what's going to be right here is the hour that you want to set it to. So say you want it to happen at 5 in the morning. I'm gonna put it at 5. Now remember the time zone is different. So for me, that would mean that if I put it at 4 mountain time, that's 5 for me. And what you're gonna really wanna make sure you do is you press include time here so that it actually takes the hour that you put in there. So now I'm gonna actually just right click this and run this module only. And if we open up this URL, we'll see that it actually set it to 4:39 a.m. And the reason for that is because I made this automation and it's using the now situation, right? So it's gonna take like the zero or the second part of what you have in there, because I only set the hour. And if you set it at like 4 a.m., it's gonna be at like zeros because it's at a zero marker on the hours. Now I could set the set minutes too, but it's a little excessive. If you just have the automation running with zeros at the end of it, it's gonna set it to the time. So if you need to have it at like 12:30 or something like that, you're gonna wanna add that as well as another layer. But for this circumstance, you can see it set the time for what I wanted. Interestingly enough, if you wanna go through and change this, what you're gonna do is you're gonna take this item here, and if we right click append to page content, since it's not gonna map to anything because I just made it one step at a time, I can append the page content by doing that. And then I could also append the page content again by doing this. And this is just like if you're in the testing scenario. But that's how you make recurring tests in make.com. If you wanna know more about this kind of stuff or want me to consult you on how to do it for your business, I would recommend checking out my services at riseproductive.com/notion-consulting. If you don't want to check that out, check out this on how to improve your productivity even more.